Number one is by living a life of focus. Can we say it together? A life of focus. Look at what he says. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus, by the command of our Savior and of Christ Jesus, our hope. Can we say that line in red together? Christ Jesus, our hope. Can you say it one more time? Christ Jesus, our hope. Do you know that Jesus Christ is our hope in this world today? Amen. Now, what I want everybody to do is I want everybody to stop for one moment. I want you to take a deep breath. I want you to do a little bit of self-analysis. Take inventory of your heart. And I want to ask you a very serious question. What right now in your life is distracting you and disrupting you from keeping Jesus Christ as your hope in all things? You don't have to give me the answer, but I want you to think about it. I want you to think about the people. I want you to think about the problems. I want you to think about the priorities that you have in your life that may actually be disrupting and distracting you from keeping Jesus Christ as your only hope in this life. I want to show you what the Apostle Paul says in Colossians chapter 3. Since then, you have been raised with Christ. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above, not on earthly things. This verb to set your heart or set your mind means to seek after, to strive earnestly for. This past week, I was at Costco, and I was pulling out of Costco. I had to take care of two tires, and as I was pulling out, I thought, "Oh wait, I got to check something in the back of my car, in the back of my truck." So before I drove out of Costco, I pulled off to the side, and when I pulled off to the side, I jumped out of the car to make sure everything was okay in the back of my truck. And when I got out, I saw this homeless person right there, and I thought to myself, I said, "God, of all the places that I would stop my car and to get out and to check what was going on with my truck, there's a homeless person right here." I was like, this is not by accident. So then I reached in my pocket, I pulled out a bill, and I raised it up in the air, and I called him over. He actually had a dog, so I didn't want to go over and get bit by the dog, so I called the guy over towards me. So as he comes over, I give him the money, and we just started talking. I wanted to get him to start talking about where he was in life, what was going on in his world, and I asked him about, you know, what is he doing to kind of break out of this trap that he's in. And as he got going, I said, "Okay, Lord, I think you've given me an opportunity now. Let me talk to him about faith in Christ." So I said to him, I said, do you believe in Jesus as your Savior?" And he took a pause and he said, "Let me tell you something." He said, when I was in prison," so this gives you an idea of the context of the conversation. He said, "When I was in prison, I would see people in prison that would come in and they would have a religious experience. They're in prison, they would start worshiping God. They would start praising God. They're in prison, they would start going to chapel. They're in prison, they would start reading their Bibles." He said, "But well, you know what I also saw? Is that the moment that they were let out of prison, they would take Jesus, throw him in the trash, walk out the prison doors, and go back to their old life." And I thought to myself, I said, "Here I came to bring a sermon to this man, and this man is bringing a sermon to me." And I thought to myself, I wonder how many people on Sunday morning come to church, but then when they walk out the doors, they throw Jesus in the trash, and they just go right back to their old life. It's easy to praise God in here. It's easy to sing praises to God and to worship him in this place. As a matter of fact, I would say it's the easiest place to worship God. This is the easy part. Do you want to know where it's hard to worship God? It's when we walk out those doors and we go into this world. But what's the only way for us to stay focused on Jesus being our hope, not just in here, but out in the world? It's right here in Colossians. Set your heart on things above. Set your mind on things above. What we need to do is ask Jesus every single day, "God, Give me a heavenly perspective to all the earthly situations that I face in my life.